The great treetop cliff towered hugely in the sunlight and cast its broad, deep shadow across the flat strip of land which lay between it and the jungle. At the center of the cliff, running its full height from base to crest, jutted an immense outcrop of solid gray rock, fantastically molded into semblance of a ruminating giant. Though craggy and rugged, old and worn, so startlingly did it look like a gargantuan statue of someone dreaming of ages long forgotten, that ever since the days of the Valles Chiapas, it had been named the Ponderer, and mightily feared.
Be still! Be still, little thing who mocks my own shape and form. So, this creature has mastery over the other thing. This one thinks. Well, well. You really do think, little one. That is something indeed. I do think. What else can one do that is worthwhile? What greater ecstasy can there be than that of sustained and involved thought? Only in thought may one avoid the torment of endless years. The long thought, the complicated thought, that is the fundamental pleasure, isn't it?
No, si.
Alas, I have arrived at the end of a beautiful problem. The problem of 9 bodies circling a binary, the 6th being retrograde. It has kept me petrified with the pleasure of thought for 70,000 years. Or was it 7,000? I don't know. It is of no consequence and not worth investigating. The solution is too swift and easy. But I would guess, little one, that even a simple puzzle would be too much for your kind, eh?
Put me down, and I will leave your feet in peace. I swear by—
Be silent. Now I am sorely in need of another thought. I yearn to be numbed by a new problem. How unhappy is this illusoid without a problem? You, little thing, have a fragmentary life which does not extend from one of my graphitic pulses to the next. And probably any puzzle you could concoct would be equally as short and futile. Yet I need a long one. I need one enjoyable for eons.
By my father and my mother, I shall never again tread upon your shade, or come within sight of here if but—
Quiet! Let me consider how I might convert you into a suitable problem. Suppose that I squeeze you. Yes, you will die. Sooner or later, others of your kind will come seeking you. I shall squeeze them also. The mystery will grow with a mound of corpses. The tale will spread like ripples when a stone has been cast into a pond. Eventually, other little things with minds superior to yours will come here to investigate the matter. If I persist, if I go far enough, some will solve the mystery and employ whatever is available to shatter me to dust.
I do not wish to die. I do not deserve to die.
Now, possibly there is a problem. Somewhat on the short side, but spiced with danger. Can I cast a stone and accurately estimate the speed, distance, and amplitude of those ripples? Can I start the chain of circumstance, petrify myself in thought, and awake in good time with the solution of how to avoid my own destruction? Ha ha ha! This is something decidedly novel. A puzzle loaded with death, my own death. It entices me. Yes, it entices me.
Pity!
What a weird concept. Has it an inherent problem? No, I cannot conceive one. However, I understand what you mean. If I grant you some of this pity, it may complicate the matters pleasingly. I will therefore grant it by playing a little game with you.
Please, put me down!
Not yet. Not just yet. If at all. The game first. This is the game. I shall release you unhurt if your wits prove the equal of mine. If you can petrify me, you will have earned your freedom. So think, little one, think. It is you versus a Silasoid.
Petrify you?
With a problem, and not some petty puzzle which can be solved within the space of a gravitic pulse, but one worthy of my time. A long, long time. Come on, petrify me with thought. That you may live. Be swift. Only the witless are slow.
To whom did God say, let there be light?
Echamula!